For more than 50 years, the Fairfield Center for Disabilities and Cerebral Palsy has been encouraging hope and fostering relationships for individuals with disabilities and cerebral palsy. The center has created a community within our local community through rich, vibrant programming. Its adult day services, offered 5 days a week, includes activities both at the center and at locations throughout the community. The center has something for each individual to connect with others and foster their unique interests and skills, helping them to lead enriched and independent lives. Through these programs, the center is constantly evolving services to meet the changing needs of Fairfield County residents with disabilities and helping to encourage hope and foster relationships, truly building a community.
IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Ohio University Lancaster, R.N. Smith Heating and Cooling, Tiki Bowling Lanes, Sheridan Funeral Home, Tiberio's Ristorante, Fairfield DD, the Edwards Insurance Agency, the Huddle Tire Company, the Lancaster Eagle Gazette, Fairfield National Bank, Personal Touch Party Rentals, Fairfield Federal, Don's Furniture, Kumler Collision and Automotive, The Carriage Company, the Fairfield Center for Disabilities, Fleet Masters, The Window Man, Ohio Christian University, the Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, North Body Shop, Kirkbride Lawn Care, Wall-to-Wall Floors, and Standing Stone Bank.
Hey, good evening, everybody. Welcome to the High School Football Game of the Week. I'm Jared Stewart alongside Tim Shoemaker. Tonight, homecoming night at Rushville. Fairfield Union High School taking on the Amanda Clear Creek Aces. And Tim, two teams coming into tonight's game looking for their first league win of the season. And both of them, realistically, feel like tonight could be the night.
Fairfield won two games in non-conference in the first three, and Amanda won one. And now they're both 0-2 in the league, and it's a big game, you know, cross-county rivalry, hard-hitting football game. And you want to get off the snide, per se, and get you a W here in the league and get it rolling.
Let's take a look at the schedules of these two teams, what they've had and then what they'll have coming up. First of all, let's take a look at Amanda Clear Creek. You mentioned 1-4 coming in.
Well, the problem is, if you look at it, basically they've had defensive issues, Jared.
Right.
Last two games gave up in league 35 to Hamilton and 27 to Taze. You know, they're giving up 29 points a game, and that's very untypical of the Aces.
Right. Let's check out Fairfield Union's schedule. You mentioned 2-3 overall, and they started off pretty good against New Lex, a rival always.
Well, and you know, they won a third game against Vinton, but the problem for the Falcons has been offense. They've only scored 44 points all year, averaging right. 8.8 points a game. It's hard to win when you're scoring just over 8 points a game.
Today's pregame is brought to you by Personal Touch Party Rentals. Carol and Eric Whittington would like to invite you to stop by Personal Touch Party Rentals and Events in Lancaster. They're a small family-owned business and have been servicing the Central Ohio and Hocking Hills area since 2003. They'd love to help you plan your next event. Graduation with a personal touch, weddings with a personal touch, even corporate events with a personal touch. They can be reached at 740-689-6991. We are just about set to kick it away. From Fairfield Union High School, the kickoff is proudly brought to you by Tiki Bowling Lanes for fun for the whole family, offering specials throughout the week. To find out more, you can visit them on the web at tikilanes.com. And, of course, tonight, Shu, our first taste of late fall weather actually kind of feels like rainy and bitter out there.
Fun for the players, not fun for the fans.
And, of course, we're going to want to keep an eye on the field conditions all night long tonight. Looks pretty good right now. Some spots that are looking a little muddy, but obviously going to take a beating throughout the night. Kickoff will be taken at the 20 by the Aces, and not much of a return, brought down at the 25. On the return for Amanda Clear Creek was Dalton Covell.
Well, the key for the Aces, as we all know, Jared, is Jordan Leisure.
Right.
You know, He's got over 600 yards this year, had over 1,800 last year. He's already scored 10 touchdowns. He is the focus of Fairfield Union. If they're going to have any success with the game tonight with Amanda, you're going to have to really, really contain Jordan.
And lining up, looks like Laser going to take a direct snap here. Typically, it's Braden Neff as the quarterback for the Aces, but that's Laser.
Well,
behind center.
It is direct snap, and you can figure right then you're kind of the Wildcat. We're going to get a run here, but.
And we had an offside call on first down there on Fairfield Union. So first and five for the Aces.
Not really how you want to start,
no.
You know, the first play of the game defensively.
Might need to have the fans in the last row wipe off our window here.
Well, if it stops raining, we'll wipe it up. Yeah. But at this point, it's kind of useless.
Blurry, yeah.
Yeah. The picture looks great on the field,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, it does. Man in motion for the Aces. He just about slipped. That's Keaton Baldwin. And another flag.
Yep.
Wow. Two plays and two penalties for the Falcons. Our Fleetmaster's mic'd up. Might be having a little bit of technical issues with his mic, but it is offsides on Fairfield Union. Two penalties in a row gives the Aces a first down. So first and 10 Aces, they've got the ball at the 36-yard line. And they have yet to run an offensive play. Now Braden Neff is in at quarterback. Baldwin resets to the near side. Neff hands it off to Leisure, and nice defense coming in there. Number nine was Jack Young for the Falcons. So they'll give him no gain. They'll say he got back to the line of scrimmage. But Jack Young, nice job reading that play. And you can just see, Shu, that the players out there, all of them, offense and defense, kind of tiptoeing around right now.
Well, until you get confident and you feel like you have your footing, it's going to be like that.
Yeah. So second and 10 for the Aces. Neff out of the short shotgun with Laser behind him. Here is Laser trying to get outside. He cuts it back up. He's got some running room across midfield to the 45 and finally brought down at the 40-yard line.
Hey, Amanda pulled the left side of their line and got a good lead block there. Leisure's so good. We've seen him before. He's just so good about getting out there hard, following his blocks.
Shu, I think no matter what division, as we see the replay here, regardless of division, I think Leisure's one of the best in Central Ohio.
He's as good as we see.
Yeah. So first and 10 for Amanda Clear Creek. Yard gain for Leisure. And the Aces in Falcon territory. Laser goes in motion. Here's a handoff to R.J. Martin, the junior. And he'll pick up. They'll mark him down at the 40, just a yard gain. Martin, a different style of runner as Laser. Martin, not as big, but he's quick. If they can get him to the outside, use Laser, you know, up the middle, maybe they can get something going on the ground. But obviously this is a game you're going to see a lot of running.
Well, in weather like this, you're glad that you emphasize the running
yeah.
game because you're going to need
it. As we look out, we can see the rain kind of blowing from right to left through the lights. Here's Laser again. And he'll get up to the 35, bring up a third down. And about three or four. Colin Woodside on the stop for the Falcons. Going to keep the ball boys busy tonight as well.
Now, I was just thinking the same thing. These kids are going to be hustling
yes,
tonight.
They are. So third down and four. Neff out of the shotgun. Here's Leisure again. And he's not going to have enough for the first down. He'll be a couple yards short. Looked like Brad Wolf in on the stop for the Falcons. So it's fourth and two for Amanda Clear Creek.
Yeah, no question here. You're kind of in a area that you really don't have any choice. You're not going to kick the ball. There's not much you would gain by kicking the ball.
And they've taken Neff out. Leisure will just take the direct snap. Leisure, direct snap, goes to the left, and they are not going to get it. Good defensive pursuit. About five Falcons got in there, led by number 36 on the stop. That's Brayden Heston.
No chance. Falcons had that defended very, very well.
So after a, there you'll see the replay right here. Yeah, Brayden Heston led it.
Yeah, he just got off block, and penetration's way too much and nowhere to go in this with the footing the way it is right now.
So after a bad start for the Falcons with two penalties in a row, they pick it up defensively as Amanda gets into their territory, and now we'll see what the Falcons can do on offense. Will Young will be under center for the Falcons, and a good run on first down. That is Heston again, I believe. So he makes the stop on defense and gets the first carry of the game for his offense.
But the Falcons have just struggled all year offensively, and if they can just get anything going and just get some momentum, it just helps them morale and the feeling of the sideline.
Second down and three for Fairfield Union. You
really
can see
shows
that rain,
the rain,
yeah.
Doesn't it?
Really coming down. And there's a big burst right up the middle. Again, it's Heston. He has the first down up to midfield. And already you can see the field conditions just deteriorating. Check this out.
Tonight's what we call a mutter.
Yeah.
Because before long, you're not going to be able
it's
to
It's
going to
be hard to see numbers on the jerseys.
Yeah, we're not going to be able to make the call.
It's already pretty difficult.
Watch your body language is what we'll have to do.
Young again to Heston, right up the middle. Same play three times in a row. And look at this, a first down run. Possibly, it might be about a yard shorter, half a yard, but they're just busting it right up the middle.
Well, why not? You know what? He just needs a small crease. He's got a good burst, and he's really, really running hard. Now he's got to run with more weight. He's got about 5 pounds of mud on him right now.
They have had some changes in that offensive unit for the Falcons. We mentioned Will Young now lining up at quarterback. Nick Schultz, who was quarterbacking them earlier in the year, has moved to wide receiver. And unfortunately, Alex Ritten, who plays a big part in this team offensively and defensively, is out for the season. Busted up a knuckle, I believe, in the Vinton County game. So they've made some changes, but right now it's working fine. Young hands off again. I believe it's Heston, and again. Give him about seven.
Yep, good hard run.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it, right?
Well, it's pretty simple right now. If you're, if you're winning, at the point of attack, don't get cute.
Yep.
Try to do things on the perimeter, and when you get in certain spots on the field too, right now, Jared, I don't know if TV does this, but there are certain spots where you're going to have better tracking than others.
They're starting to get where they're going to have not as good tracking, and here's Will Young getting sacked in the backfield. Looked like they were going to try to run an option, and the Aces snuffed that one out there. Yeah, looked like Leisure in on the tackle.
Yeah, that's a big play for the Amanda defense after being gouged there several plays in a row.
They'll give them forward progress. They'll stop it at the 37, so it's a loss of four. Second and 14. No score here early on at homecoming night at Fairfield Union. Just unfortunate when you have homecoming against your rival and you get weather like this. Young Sends his man in motion. That's Nick Schultz. He'll take the pitch. Schultz with lots of running room, and he gets up across the 30, inside the 25, and another first down for the Falcons.
You know, with the way the field is right now, those quick hitters are the way to go. You know, they've busted it inside quickly, and that was a quick toss, and let him run with it. I still think it's an advantage for the offense in this weather,
yeah.
Jared, because you know where you're going.
Right. It's a very good point. I mean, when you're playing defense, you don't know which way the guy's going to cut. If he makes it, you know, fairly quick cut, you're slipping and falling.
Yeah, you're not even sure where anything's going, and then you have to make an adjustment. And you
look
can
at that
see.
Shot.
It's actually gotten worse since we started.
Yeah. I'm just going to have to rely on the I can't see out the window. Young hands it off again. It's Schultz. Whoa, he slips as he's trying to cut back, and he'll be brought down. A loss on the play. It looked like 72 getting in on the tackle. That's Owen Dunlap, I believe. That's who that was for the Aces.
As you can see, it's coming in sheets. But, you know, those kind of plays that take a little longer to develop just aren't going to be as successful.
Right.
And I know it's easy from up here, but in all honesty, Fairfield's done a great job when they've had the quick hitting plays.
Yep.
There you go. And you see they've modified their wing here, Jared.
Yeah.
Like we saw with Fisher last week, backs were – not necessarily on the wings. It's not as traditional.
Here's that pitch out to Schultz again. He's trying to get to the outside, and he's not going to make it. He'll pick up a yard back to the original line of scrimmage. Jordan Lazier again on the stop for the Aces.
Yeah, good play, though. You know, he's going forward at least, and where some of the other ones that take a little longer to develop, you're just not going to be able to have timing.
The shot you were seeing was from Tom Russo, and that's Tom right there. He's taking the brunt of the rain right now for our crew. Third down and 10. Young back to pass. He's got a man wide open. That's Heston. Heston up across the 15, and he's mad at himself as he's slipping. Not much you can do there.
No. Nice call, though. Nice execution by the Falcons.
And that makes it a lot more manageable fourth down.
Oh, yeah, you're looking at 3.5-4 yards now, and that's very doable.
Obviously, it's going to be a kicking game is going to be non-existent tonight.
Very non-existent.
So they'll spot it at the 14. That makes it a fourth down and 3. Young again with Heston right behind him. Schultz is flanked out to the right. Young back to pass looking, and it was incomplete. He had a man open, and it falls incomplete. It was intended for Steven Dixon.
Pretty good throw.
I thought
it got there and where it could have been caught, but good pressure by the defender.
Check the replay here. Falcons were wanting a pass interference.
Well, players were.
True. You'll see in the end zone, number 12. Oh, there's an arm wrapped around him.
Yeah, that could have been.
Yeah.
But probably a good no call,
right?
Honestly.
So the Aces take over on downs, first and 10, at their own 14-yard line. Neff back in under center with Lazier right behind him. Here is Lazier right up the middle, and once again, nothing doing there. Like 66 leading the charge for the Falcons. Stop this time. That's Matt Prysock.
Well, there's no reason not to focus anywhere else. I mean, you know, Jordan's that good, and you know, to Amanda's credit, Coach Hinton, they're going to ride him because he's so good.
They'll give him a gain of 1, so it's 2nd and 9. Here's Lazier again coming near side. And you saw just how much carry takes in trying to cut back. Yeah, it's going to be a game where it's going to be tough to do anything, really.
It is. Falcon pursuit was really good, too.
Shoot, do they still make the football cleats where you can change out the size of the cleat on the bottom?
You know what? There's been some rule changes with it, and I'm not 100% sure exactly. That's a good question, Jared. We probably ought to get some research on and find out.
Yeah. on a night like tonight, you'd certainly want the longest cleats you could get. As the clock rolls down to 2 minutes to play here in this first quarter, no score. Third down and eight. Neff, long snap count. Here's Leisure. And he will get up near the 20-yard line. And that will bring up a fourth and five.
That's Jordan's eighth carry already in the ball game, so
he does pretty much everything. He's the punter here. You'll see a replay of that last run.
Just good job by the Falcons, you know, and like I said, really, why else would you focus anywhere else?
Yeah. Leisure does not come out of the game. He runs the ball almost every play. He punts. He plays defense. We've already called his name several times, making tackles.
Yeah, we talked before the game what a good athlete he is, and we'll talk about some of his other accomplishments.
The punt goes out of bounds. Not sure why the flag came in. They're going to mark it all the way up.
Wow.
Looked to me like it went out at the 40.
44, I thought, being right in front of us.
Okay, it's a sideline warning. You can already see him making the motion. He was trying to run up the field, apparently, and maybe ran into somebody on the sideline.
On the defense. That's number one.
There you hear on the Fleet Masters mic'd up, you can hear just how windy it is down on the field as well. There's our referees tonight, Shoe.
Well, our list, you can see that Lee Hubbard is the referee. The umpire's Morgan Stevens. The linesman, Dale Wheatley. The line judge is James Staten. And the back judge is James Brown.
So it was technically just a warning, not a penalty.
Don't get me started on the sideline penalty thing.
And remember, well, in fact, it was the last Fairfield Union League win against Bloom Carroll here. There were, remember, I think Bloom Carroll was hurt by it.
They were flagged by it.
Yeah, because they had a warning and then they were flagged by it.
Yeah, that was a double overtime victory for the Falcons.
And we had that game here for you, our game of the week.
Yeah, that was back in 2012.
Game had a little bit of everything. A couple of overtimes, lightning delay. Here's a handoff to Heston. Heston has some room across the 40. Look at that, number 18 for the Aces. Landon Roberts was just holding on for dear life, and Heston was not going down.
I tell you what, he's playing purposeful. And what I mean by that is he's not just going through it and whatever. He's playing with a purpose. Watch him here as he pushes off, fights the defender for yards.
Look at him dragging him.
Oh, he's battling.
How about
I
that?
Love it. What great effort.
That's a great run by Heston.
Sure is.
Braden Heston, who is a junior, 5'6", 185 pounder. There's a fumble on the snap, and I think Will Young – no, it's still loose. And the Aces are saying they have it, but I think the Falcons, one of their backs in the backfield, was able to fall on it. Although an Aces player is holding the ball right now and telling the referee, here it is.
Well, we'll see what the officials come up with.
And it is Aces football.
Wow.
Let's see it here.
Yeah, he just bumped the lineman coming out of there in wet football.
Look at that. Unbelievable.
See, that's where we thought the Fairfield Union player had it, but you never know what goes on the bottom of those piles.
Yeah. And I don't know how long the replay goes, but here later on, an Aces player ends up, as they're trying to get the scrum separated, an Aces player holds the football up to the referee, says, here, I've got it. So it's Aces football, first and 10 at their own 37-yard line.
Boy, on a night like this, you take every break you can get. Power to the left here.
We'll give it to Leisure, trying to get over that left tackle, and it's going to be a gain of just about two or three on the play. There you see just how we're still running down here in the first quarter. Time's going to run out in the first quarter. You see the rain, the mud there on Jordan Leisure.
Like I said, fun for the players tonight.
That's true. So time will run out here in the first quarter. No score. in Rushville on Fairfield Union's homecoming night. And Shu, with the break in the action, gives us a chance to thank some sponsors.
Thanks to Fairfield Medical Center, improving quality of life through patient care and education. Fairfield Medical Center is people you know and care you trust. And imagine your possibilities at the Ohio University Lancaster campus in Pickerington Center. They are transforming lives and transforming communities by providing access to an affordable college education close to home. 12 bachelor's degrees and 14 associate degree programs can be completed on campus. For more information, you can visit ohio.edu/Lancaster/imagine. And let's also say thanks to your community newspaper, the Lancaster Eagle Gazette. It gives you news, weather, sports, and so much more at LancasterEagleGazette.com. For up-to-date game stats, look for them on Twitter at #EagleGazette.
And I'll also tell you that you've been hearing our referee mic'd up. That's brought to you by Fleet Masters. For over 20 years, Fleet Masters has provided medium and heavy-duty truck repairs for our customers throughout central and southeastern Ohio. They're located locally owned and operated with their 10,000-square-foot facility located at 202 Quarry Road in Lancaster. Visit them online, FleetMastersLLC.com. So we'll go into the second quarter with no score on a rainy, chilly night here in Fairfield Union as it's their homecoming night. They had their festivities earlier tonight, and we want to say congratulations to Molly Myers, who was crowned the homecoming queen. And we will see some footage of that after this play. Second down and 7 for the Aces. Neff looking to pass, and it's intercepted at the 48-yard line. That's Jacob Figgins on the interception for the Falcons.
Well, as we said, turnovers are big, and you turn it right back over and get it on the first pass from the Aces.
It looked like the receiver he was throwing to, you'll see it here, was not even looking. I don't know what looked like laser he's trying to hit.
I think he's
just
trying,
overthrew him.
He's trying to run the back out of the backfield, and it just wasn't coordinated. The timing wasn't good.
Tonight's replays are brought to you by Kumler Collision and Automotive, a full-service auto body repair facility. Kumler Collision has been performing high-quality, guaranteed auto body repairs in the Lancaster area since 1928. Falcons are in an area of the field right now where they have not seen a lot of action, so maybe a little bit better footing right here. First and 10. Here's Schultz on the pitch out, gets up to the 40, gain of 2. I think we're going to see some footage of the earlier festivities. There you go. Molly Myers, crowned queen. And that's Big Tom, isn't it? The king that plays basketball. And the king plays basketball and baseball.
He does.
Tom Green.
Yep.
Thomas Green. So look at that. He even got the crowner. How about that? So congratulations to Thomas Green and Molly Myers. Here's a handoff up the middle. That's Brad Wolf on the carry.
Yeah, he used a back for a lead blocker there. That just puts another blocker in that path, and he wasn't far from really gaining some big yardage.
Yeah, you're right.
Nice play.
Brad will stay in the ball game for another play. Third down and 5 for the Falcons. Brad, a transfer from Lancaster, as well as Will Young, who is the starting quarterback. And Coach Bain will call a timeout. How about Coach Bain with the shorts and the short sleeves?
He's old school,
on a rainy, cold night.
Yep, Coach Bain's old school.
Hey, our scoreboard sponsor is Buffalo Wild Wings. We want to thank Larry Tipton and the gang. They have some great food, also great service, and the best sports viewing in town at Buffalo Wild Wings. It's all in the Plaza Shopping Center on North Memorial Drive. And remember, for every one of our games of the week, Buffalo Wild Wings will have the instant replay televised after the game at the Buffalo Wild Wings Lancaster location. And, of course, we want to give a chance to thank our crew. These guys do a great job. They come out in the rain and set up. They do the game in the rain, and they'll tear it down in the rain. On cameras tonight, Jason Roush, Dave Bickham, and Tom Russo out in the weather tonight. In the truck, Bob Compenny, our producer-director. Aaron Newell on graphics and replays. Also, Shane Messina on graphics. And I think Beth Compenny's with us tonight on stats. And we have an early score report in the Mid-State League Buckeye. Logan Elm leads Liberty Union 7-0. There you see Tom. He's a trooper, isn't he?
I'm just glad that we're here, Jared.
I think Dave's glad he's on the camera tonight, not down on the sideline.
I thought he could have done both duties tonight. What do you think?
I agree. Third and five for the Falcons. Young looking to pass. Going to loft one down there. Man-to-man coverage, and it is going to fall incomplete. It was intended for Nicholas Bishop. So fourth down and five. Actually, looks closer to four for the Falcons. Steven Dixon will run the play in for Fairfield Union. Young has Brad Wolf right behind him. That's who takes it. No, Young takes it himself, and he's got enough for the first down.
Nice.
Good decision by Will Young.
Well, it's the first time they've done that. You run the quarterback follow. You fake and follow, and that's a nice play out of this offense.
Good shot right there at Will Young. First and 10 for the Falcons. They're in Aces territory at the 31-yard line. Look at that rain still coming down. Who was it in the truck that said, oh, it's going to stop by 7? Young hands it off to Wolf, and not a lot there. He's going to be brought down after maybe a yard gain up to the 30. So second down and 9. Menard on the tackle for the Aces. I would guess that a lot of games tonight, Shu, on grass are going to be low scoring.
Yeah, there's no doubt. And it even affects the turf, quite like we'll see here.
Young sends his man in motion. Then he'll hand it off to Schultz. There's a hole there. Schultz up to the 20. He's gone.
Yep.
Touchdown, Falcons.
Little inside counter. Caught him off guard. You know, influenced him, and Amanda overshot it. And good run by Schultz.
How about that offensive line as well?
Yeah. Nice call, though, because, you know, everybody's kind of flowing toward where the plays are going, and they caught him off guard on a little inside, you know, and brought that back across the defense, and there just wasn't anybody there.
So the Falcons on the board first with the run by Nick Schultz. Will Young will do the extra point duties. It'll be out of the hold of Spencer Conrad. You can see the flag blowing right at into the face of the kicker. And Young gets it up, and, oh, no good. Here it looked good, but it's no good. I guess wide left.
It's hard to tell from here.
It really is. Yeah. I can't tell.
Yeah. But it appeared as though he pulled it left.
But the Falcons are on the board after a turnover from Amanda Clear Creek. You'll see the scoring drive coming up momentarily. So the Falcons take advantage of the interception, and there you go.
Yeah, short field, 40 yards, but did a nice job executing. Of course, you get a big play. Watch right here, this inside counter. Nice cut right there.
Yeah, real nice.
Yeah. Good blocking, and then gets outside, and there's just no way anybody's going to catch him at that point.
And Shu, we mentioned briefly in the pregame that both these teams looking for their first win in mid-state league play this year. Fairfield Union, of course, looking for their first one in 21 tries. And, and realistically, they've got a good shot tonight, as well as Amanda does too.
Well, unfortunately, they've had 21 straight league losses. The last one we did was where they defeated BC here back on 9/21 in 2012 in that double overtime game. So, you know what? You just want to get rid of that and move on and stay focused and try to win a league game.
Well, we've seen this Fairfield Union team over the last few years, and this team this year, obviously, I think looks to be heading in the right direction as opposed to the last couple of years?
Hey, it's tough. You know, the league's good. We've talked about the Buckeye division year in, year out, yep. and you start looking at it, and last night you take a team like Circle, yep. averaging 37 points a game, goes to Bloom-Carroll and gets shut out.
Yep.
The division's tough. It's tough to win games.
Neff under center, sends two guys to reset to the left. He's got Brett Buzzard split out wide to the near side. He pitches out. Here's Lazier. Lazier gets out to about the 40-yard line, pick up a four on the play. Second down and six for the Aces. You know, if you're a wide receiver like Brett Buzzard here, number four, split out to the other side, 22, Lance Clevenger, it's going to be a boring night for you.
Well, you know what, though? They come in to play big on the block.
That's true.
You know, as far as catching, yeah, it's going to be pretty, pretty slow. Strong left line here. You see the shift.
Neff, again to Leisure, takes a hit right at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards. Is that 13 getting in there? That's
it was.
Michael Jude. So far tonight, the Falcons have held Leisure in check.
Well, like I said, you know, your focus has got to be there. Now you have to execute it.
Yeah.
You can't just talk about it and walk through. You actually have to have some technique and effort toward it, and they've done that all night.
That's a young offensive line as well for Amanda Clear Creek.
Yeah, Coach Hinton, you know, you had an opportunity to share some information with him and have him share with you and talk about some things. And, you know, that's been one of the concerns they knew coming in it was going to take. They don't have a senior on the
right.
line.
Of course, the starting quarterback, Braden Neff, just a sophomore. Here's a big hole. There goes Leisure up across midfield, and he's going to get up to about the 44-yard line. A good run for Leisure. And just as we mentioned, that offensive line, they open up a hole for Jordan.
You can see here, watch the burst.
Yeah, over on that right side.
And 19 yards, you'll take that.
Yep. So first and 10 Aces in Falcon territory at the 44. Leisure again, and maybe a gain of two this time to the 41. 7-12 and counting here in this first half. Falcons lead at 7-0. Or I'm sorry, 6-0. They missed the extra point.
Yeah, you got to remember Leisure, and you know we talked about how good athlete he is. He was 45-3 on the wrestling team last year, and he qualified for the state track meet in 110-meter
wow.
hurdles, and that says a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a three-sport athlete right there.
Absolutely.
For you. Give him great credit.
Here he is again, pitching out, and not going to be a whole lot there. He's going to be brought down. Looked like number nine coming in there for the Falcons. That's Jack Young. You're mentioning Jordan Leisure and his three-sport accomplishments, and I spent 3 years teaching at Amanda Clear Creek, and I can attest he's just a good kid as well, good student,
yeah.
good kid. He's involved in a lot of things. He's an office helper, and you know he's one of those kids that will help the younger kids as well. And he's just that's what you want out of one
good.
Of your leaders.
That's good to hear, Jared. That makes you just like him even that much more.
Absolutely. Very humble kid. Third down and eight. For the Aces, need to get to the 33.5, it looks like. Leisure trying to get outside and not going to get out there very far. He's going to pick up a few.
I think just a yard,
yeah,
Jared.
Just a yard.
That's his 15th carry so far in this
wow.
half.
It's like Hunter Sunkel coming in there to help on the tackle. So fourth down and
about six, isn't it?
Yeah, six
Five
or seven.
Six.
And the Aces will punt. It will be Leisure to do it.
Yeah, I think this is a good call right here, to be honest with you. See if they can turn field position.
And a good a good job by the Aces getting down there and downing it at the 10.
Yeah, he didn't want to quite touch it then, but there not a lot you could do to get out of the way.
That was Keaton Baldwin, number 15. He's been one of their leading tacklers this year.
Yeah, that's nice. That's a nice play. That's a good call. You turn to field position. Now if you can get a break, you're going to rely on your defense a little bit here to maybe get the ball back for you one way or the other in good field position.
Yeah.
I like that call by Coach Hinton.
So first and 10 for the Falcons. Young. Oh, they've got movement in the backfield. No flag. Now it comes in. Fleetmaster's call will back the Falcons up. I tell you what, Shu, there's some loyal fans right there, young fans at that. Don't you have an umbrella like that?
Mine's just a little different. There you go.
Yeah. Wow. Was that a tent I saw over there?
Like a mini tent, isn't it?
Look at that.
Yeah.
Can't beat that.
That's the way to go if you're going to sit in this stuff. It's like monsoon out here right now. I mean, but eventually it will stop, Jared. According to people in the truck, it will stop.
It's blowing completely sideways right now. Second down and 11 or 12 for the Falcons. Young with Heston behind him. Sunk in motion. Here's Heston. Tell you what. The first hit's not going to bring Heston down.
Nah, he's been a breath of fresh air to the Falcon offense.
I think we're going to have a replay here. Watch how he lowers his shoulder. 36 coming out of the backfield here. Watch this.
Nah, he just run through that and run through you.
Yeah, one guy's not going to bring him down. So third down and 7. As the clock rolls down inside of 4 minutes to play in the first half. And a whistle and a timeout. Coach Bain will take one. Our timeouts tonight are brought to you by the Carriage Company, located at 1031 North Memorial Drive. You can check out their website at carriagecompany.com. And sure, you've got some other sponsors we can thank tonight?
Sure. Let's say thanks to Standing Stone Bank. Whether you're ready to tackle a mortgage loan or need cash for home improvements, make Standing Stone Bank the key player in your home or business financial plans. Business to business, neighbor to neighbor. Let's grow this town together. Standing Stone Bank, an equal housing lender. Member FDIC.
You want to know how much rain we've gotten? Look at that shot. But I tell you what, they're... You know, it was a late-arriving crowd, but it's a pretty for the conditions we have, it's a good crowd out there.
Considering the circumstances, it's frustrating when you're looking at it. I mean, when you're looking at it from a financial gain or aspect, it's frustrating because, you know, we've talked about a football game is not a football game. It's a community event. And, you know, when you have a team across county, this is like West and East County right here.
Yep.
You get big crowds because people don't have to travel far. There's a history, so.
Got to wipe off the cameras tonight. Third down and 8 for the Falcons. And Heston is brought down. And now I think the Aces going to call a timeout, aren't they? Yeah, the Aces call a timeout.
Yes.
They're going to get a chance to get the ball in pretty good field position here with – right around 3 minutes to go in the half.
Nah, it's a really good call on the punt and good execution.
Even the officials are slopping through it tonight.
As we said, it's a mutter.
Is the Liberty Union and Logan Elm game at Liberty Union or is that Logan Elm?
I'm not sure. We had an update at the end of a quarter. Logan Elm was up 14.
Okay. You know, they've always had some issues out there on their field with mud and night like
Liberty
tonight.
Union.
Yeah.
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 And, you know, Terry Holbert's down at Logan Elm now, so it's kind of nice to see him having some success carry over from Millersport last year.
After they lost the opening game of the season, but they've run off four straight.
Yep, and that's good for things to happen to good people, good things. Sometimes it takes a while, but we're glad for Terry.
So fourth down and looks like six, seven for the Falcons.
Yeah, right in between, I think.
Will Young will punt it away. Back for the Aces is number 18, Landon Roberts, and also number 22, Lance Clevenger. Young gets a punt away.
Yep.
Pretty good high punt.
It is.
He gave his coverage team a chance to get down there, and it will be downed at the 46-yard line.
Yeah, it's about as good as you could ask for. You know, you were kicking from the 14, so.
You know, not a lot of footing down there.
Nah, you do the math, 32 yards with no return. You'll take that. That's about as good as you're going to get on this kind of night.
Yeah, a nice job by the coverage team to get down there and down it. Whoa. It's that kind of night.
Yeah, unfortunately, you don't want to see anybody get hurt. I mean, that's a good way to have a leg injury, and you certainly don't want that.
3:23 to play in the half. Aces trail it by six, 6-0, and they have the football. Neff will hand it off to Leisure. Leisure, I thought he was going to break through there, and somebody got the shoestring. I think that was 45 for the Falcons grabbing the shoestring. That's Colin Woodside. But still a pickup of six on the play.
Yeah, I think they're going to give him five. You can see here, right there, I thought, oh, no, he's got the hole. But luckily for the Falcons, one of their guys got him tripped up.
Neff pitches out to Leisure. Breaks one tackle. That was Schultz, and then he just slipped down inside the 40 at about the 38. We might have to find out at halftime about the cleat length and if they still make those type of cleats and if there's a rule against it.
Well, I'm not sure the type of cleat, the length anymore, the restrictions and change in
well,
that.
And, of course, you know, even if they could, they probably wouldn't be able to do it till halftime. Both these teams, you know, players play both ways, most of them.
That's true.
Offense and defense. Wouldn't be any time to change them. Third down and two for the Aces. Neff kind of bobbled the snap, and he's just going to keep it himself and maybe get back to the line of scrimmage. And he lost a yard, so it's going to bring up a fourth down and three. Neff heads all the way back and over to the sideline to get the play. Wow, they better hurry.
Yeah, they're going to have to use the timeout.
Yeah, he ran all the way. Not only did he run to the sideline, but he ran 15 yards back and over to the sideline to get the play.
Yeah, the back judge back here. He's going to raise his hand.
His hand is up now.
That's 5 seconds.
They're going to get a penalty here. Yep. Here it comes, yep.
Boy, that's a big call.
Yeah.
Play of game.
It's like the Aces just didn't know what play they wanted to run.
That's fine. You know, you have a timeout, then use it.
Yeah.
You know what? There's a big difference between fourth and eight and fourth and three.
Yep. And now you're most likely going to take that timeout into the locker room with you.
Now they're going to look like they're going to punt it, Jared.
Yeah. So Leisure to punt. And he will finally punt it. Pretty good one. Takes an Aces roll down inside the 10 and will be downed at the 9.
Yeah, almost identical to the same spot where the prior one was.
Brett Buzzard got down there to down it. So the Falcons will take over with a minute 38 showing on the clock.
Yeah, I'm just surprised the Aces had two timeouts. You just didn't take one there and kind of get regrouped. And
yeah.
Just a little shocked.
It's kind of a strange
scenario there.
I mean, Neff ran back 15 yards and all the way over to the sideline to get the play from the coach, and there was just no time to get back out there and get it. So first and 10, Falcons. Young sends Sunkwin motion, hands off to the first man. No, he keeps it. And he's going to make something out of nothing, get about 5 on the play. And now the Aces will call a timeout. Coming up at halftime, we'll have our halftime band show. And, Shoe, we have a couple more sponsors we want to thank.
Well, let's say thanks to Infinitely Outdoors, which is not the place to be tonight. provides a complete, not infinitely, but just outdoors.
Right, right.
It provides a complete design center for all your outdoor needs, including design and build services for soft and hardscapes. We also design and build water features. You need rocks, holy, pink, green, black, they have them. Check out their fall pumpkins and mums, which are now in stock, and the big green egg when visiting them. Infinitely Outdoors is conveniently located at 450 West Fair Avenue across from Goodville, where we take the comforts of the inside out. And let's
coming up,
say thanks
go ahead.
To Wall-to-Wall Floors, where customer satisfaction is their top priority. They carry a wide variety of brand-name carpet, vinyl hardwood, engineered wood, tile, and laminate flooring. You can visit them on the web at walltowallfloors.com.
Second down and 4 for the Falcons. Young with a hard snap count. Will hand off to the first man through, and he's not going to have enough for the first down. It's going to bring up a third and about 1.
Yeah, they're going to take their last one.
Yeah.
Manda's going to take the last time out here.
So with a minute and 15 showing on the clock, coming up we'll have our halftime show brought to you by North Body Shop, and we'll tell you about North Body Shop. They provide quality customer service, parts, and reliability. Since 1979, they've been doing that. Owner Mark North will provide you with a free written warranty on each estimate. That's Mark North of North Body Shop. He'll treat you right. And coming up in that North Body Shop halftime, you'll see the band show. So not just the football players and the officials out there traipsing through the mud, but the band will be out in it too. And as we check some scores, you mentioned earlier that Logan Elm leads Liberty Union 14-0. And looks like Lancaster is up on Groveport 7-0. Still in the first quarter, 7:43 to play in the first quarter. Of course, that game starting at 7:30 rather than 7.
The OCC starts at 7:30,
yeah.
You're correct.
And right now, that looks to be the only update that I have. On third down and 1, the Falcons run it right up the middle, and I think they got the first down.
Yep. Now they're saying there's a loose ball.
Uh-oh. The Aces are saying they have it. Officials are trying to sort it out. And no, Falcons come up with it. So first down, first and 10 for the Falcons. So they'll reset the chains and start the clock. So it'll roll down inside of a minute before they get this snap off. As Steven Dixon runs in the play.
Yeah, at this point, you just don't want a mistake here if you're the Falcons. I'm kind of surprised they're really not just going kneel on it with the man out of timeout.
Yeah, that's true.
At this point,
you definitely don't want a turnover here. Young hands it off to Schultz. Schultz up to the 25. Gain of 2. Seems like the entire game has been played right there between the 10 and 30.
Been a lot of plays
on the left
run
side
through
of the field.
That. Yep.
Well, you've got Green down on the other on the right side. So the clock is going to wind down, and the Falcons will take a 6-0 lead into the locker room here at halftime on homecoming night over the Amanda Clear Creek Aces. And we want you to invite you to stay tuned for our halftime band show, which is being brought to you by Frank E. Smith Funeral Home. Crematory and Monuments, family-owned and operated since 1889. Their website at funeralhome.com will guide you through the choice of dignified funeral services and monuments with personalized options. Respect for tradition, regard for change. Halftime Band Show also brought to you by Fairfield Federal. Fairfield Federal is pleased to announce a new look and upgrade to their internet banking and bill pay service. In addition to a more secure login, they've added many exciting new features. You can also save time and do your banking on the go. Available now on your smartphone. Look for their app in the marketplace. Fairfield Federal, internet banking that revolves around you. Member FDIC, equal housing lender. Halftime score, Fairfield Union 6, Amanda Clear Creek nothing. Halftime Band Show coming up next on the High School Football Game of the Week.
Does she walk? Does she talk? Does she come complete? My homeroom angel always pulled me from my seat. She was pure like snowflakes. No one could ever stain the memory of...
IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Ohio University Lancaster, R.N. Smith Heating and Cooling, Tiki Bowling Lanes, Sheridan Funeral Home, Tiberio's Ristorante, Fairfield DD, The Edwards Insurance Agency, The Huddle Tire Company, The Lancaster Eagle Gazette, Fairfield National Bank, Personal Touch Party Rentals, Fairfield Federal, Don's Furniture, Kumler Collision and Automotive, The Carriage Company, The Fairfield Center for Disabilities, Fleet Masters, The Window Man, Ohio Christian University, The Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, North Body Shop, Kirkbride Lawn Care, Wall-to-Wall Floors, and Standing Stone Bank.
Hi, I'm Zane Harshaw. I am 20 years old, and I've been playing guitar for 5 years. I started on Guitar Hero when I was like 13 and 14. Then I stopped playing and I told them I want to play the real thing. So I was a fast learner. They said, I've got the gift from God. Well, I like to play rock, a little bit of blues, jazz, and I played reggae. Yeah, a little R&B and Christian music, like when, if I go to church or something. I play by ear, so I listen to it a couple times, then I play along with it sometimes, then I memorize it. Some other guitar players saying, Zane, you're way too good on the guitar. I like to play in front of a lot of people. I want them to say, Blue Spectrum, we love you.
Experience the Huddle Tire difference. Locally owned and operated since 1910, we're your independent tire and auto repair shop. We carry all major brands of tires, including Goodyear, Cooper, BF Goodrich, and many more. But we're more than just tires. From safety inspections to alignments, brakes, shocks, and struts, even preventive maintenance, we can handle it all. Enjoy the ride at Huddle Tire Company, 300 South Columbus Street, or we can be reached at our website at huddletire.com.
Are you having problems with your heating and cooling system? Is your unit not as efficient as it should be? Replacing your home heating and cooling system is a major decision, one that shouldn't rely on cost alone. To enjoy better, cleaner air today, call R.N. Smith Heating and Air Conditioning. We feature Trane air conditioners, heat pumps, ventilation systems, thermostats, parts, service, and much more. It's hard to stop a Trane. R.N. Smith Heating and Air Conditioning, now in their fourth generation, with a fleet of over 20 installation and service units, here to provide you with total customer satisfaction.
This is a special place. A place that is leading the way. Serving society. instilling values, preparing today's workforce, eternally focused. This is Ohio Christian University.
My name's Jessica Armstrong. I'm 20 years old, and I'm an artist at Blue Shoe Arts. I just really love it, and it's something I love doing. I mean, I've been able to do it since I was a kid, and then my art talent just grew. It's really important to me, and I always dreamed of becoming a professional. Well, I use it to express my feelings, and sometimes the way I can see art, what I can imagine, and sometimes what I can think of. Art can be described in lots of things, not just the oil. It could be described in many things, and either way you look at it, it's still kind of art, just a different form. I mean, art can be described in different emotions as well as happiness. That's what it takes to be a great artist. You can't describe it in all different ways, not just happiness. It takes a lot of practice and a lot of work just to get there. That's what my dad always says. I hope that people really enjoy my special talents. I mean, that's what art basically is. It's like a window into a person's mind.
Shake off the cold and join the Marching Falcons as they shut up and dance. Listen to me. I am captain of the track team.
She doesn't really think she's going to get out of here, does she?
Be nice. She's new.
Hello, is anyone there?
Wow. Even from our standards, you look awful.
Oh, sweetie, what happened?
Me? My friend Becky got to talk to this super cute boy, and I tried to act like I wasn't jealous, but I so totally was. And then out of nowhere, this concrete barrier just popped up. Maybe it was a semi.
You mean you were driving?
Yeah. I mean, I know the whole eyes on the road thing, but this was a super important text. Maybe you have to know, Becky.
Texting? Great.
But it was only like 5 seconds, and I'm a really, really fast texter, so it wasn't even a big deal. Actually, has she texted me back yet? Wow, I get like no bars in this place. I wonder if they have Wi-Fi here.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Why are you stabbing me with it?
They want to help, but don't know how. Teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Ohio University Lancaster, R.N. Smith Heating and Cooling, Tiki Bowling Lanes, Sheridan Funeral Home, Tiberio's Ristorante, Fairfield DD, the Edwards Insurance Agency, the Huddle Tire Company, the Lancaster Eagle Gazette, Fairfield National Bank, Personal Touch Party Rentals, Fairfield Federal, Don's Furniture, Kumler Collision and Automotive, the Carriage Company, the Fairfield Center for Disabilities, Fleet Masters, the Window Man, Ohio Christian University, the Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, North Body Shop, Kirkbride Lawn Care, Wall-to-Wall Floors, and Standing Stone Bank.
Welcome back to Fairfield Union High School. It is halftime, where the Falcons lead it 6-0 over the Amanda Clear Creek Aces here on homecoming night. Our first half summary report is brought to you by Sheridan Funeral Home. Sheridan Funeral Home is proud to be supporting high school football. They've been serving the communities of Lancaster and Fairfield County for over 100 years. And tonight's halftime stats are brought to you by Don's Furniture, located at 1118 East Main Street. They've been serving Lancaster and Fairfield County area for 23 years. Over those years, Don's has supported numerous charities and youth sports teams, and they continue to support our community. Don's values every customer and wishes all area teams a successful season. To find out more, you can visit them on the web at donsfurniture.com. And our Beth Competti down in the truck doing a nice job on statistics tonight. As you see them there, the rushing yards are pretty much all there is for either team. Fairfield Union definitely leading that battle with 116 rushing yards to Amanda Clear Creek's 68. Amanda Clear Creek no passing yards to the Falcons 7. And just one score tonight as Fairfield Union took it in on a Nick Schultz run from about 15 yards out. But, Shu, I think the stat of the night, really, obviously it's rushing, but you've got Jordan Lazier with already 17 carries tonight.
17 carries and 72 yards. You know, to say Coach Hinton's riding the horse that brung him.
Yeah,
he's certainly riding him. And, you know, why not?
Yeah.
He's tremendous back. And, you know, how many times have we thought, oh, boy, just going to break that one. And right there, and give credit to the Falcon defense and their pursuit, gang tackling. They are just done a really nice job defensively.
Just a miserable night outside. If you were out in the elements watching this game, you're pretty miserable. It's been rainy. It's been windy and cold. And if you're a player on the field, you're, of course, not much dryness in your uniforms. As we check some scores, halftime score, Logan Elm leads Liberty Union 20-7 at halftime. Lancaster leads Groveport Madison 14-0, still in the second quarter. So, again, low-scoring affairs, but sure, I was checking some other scores from around the surrounding area. The weather doesn't seem to be slowing down Tri-Valley. They lead West M 48-0 at halftime. Well, I'm assuming that's at West M on the turf. I'm sorry, at Tri-Valley
on
the turf.
Yeah, that's at Jack Anderson tonight. Yeah, they, you know, the MVL, of the teams in the MVL, I believe 5 of the 9 team, might be 6, I'd have to recalculate, but I think have turf fields.
That's true.
And that says a lot about the Muskegon Valley League.
You've got Tri-Valley, you have Sheridan, Maysville, New Philo
Lexington.
Now does, New Lex,
John Glenn. That's 6. West does not.
West and Morgan and Crooksville, right?
Nope.
That's it.
So 6 of the 9, two-thirds of the league has turf.
Very impressive.
It is. It's a commitment that your community has to make.
And you wonder, you know, obviously looking at the conditions here tonight, I mean, when you look at that, you start thinking in your mind what could be saved and how many – and really in the long run, how much could be made with having turf.
Well, there's actually – I watched a thing on the national news just last night, and there's some concerns about the turf thing that have come up with the rubber pellets made from tire and I don't know. There's been no data yet to support it, but there's been some issues with those pellets getting into eyes and things like that. So, you know what? I think until all that data gets gathered and then you have some information, but gosh, you look how convenient it is for school districts and facilities that, you know, tomorrow there's a scheduled soccer game here at Fairfield Union tomorrow. There's no way.
No.
The ball will not travel in that gym.
No, it won't.
No, so they'll have to play, you know, on another field somewhere. So, you know, from that convenience in baseball, I know like at Zanesville High School, I talked to Coach Balow before time.
Yep.
They practice in the spring when it's bad out.
Right.
They can still go practice on one corner of the field down there that they have the turf. So it does a lot for your whole district. You can play all your sporting events. You can do all your band practice. You can do all your things, and the turf doesn't get torn up.
Another score that I saw out of the MVL was Sheridan over Maysville, 7-6.
Well, that's a big ball game tonight. Yeah. You know, Maysville's like close to the top of their district, their region in computer points, and they are at the top of the league right now. And Sheridan's right there in division, I believe it's 4.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, next week we'll get in to start talking the playoffs. I mean, you got to remember.
It's early now.
Yeah,
week 6.
Yeah, we just started the second half of the season. Now, next week you'll be able to start smelling it a little bit.
That's
so
true.
We'll talk more about it.
Second half kick is in the air, and there's a flag. Our kickoff is proudly brought to you by Tiki Bowling Lanes. For fun for the whole family, offering specials throughout the week. To find out more, you can visit them on the web at tikilanes.com.
Now, we just talked about this. That ball didn't go out of bounds, but we talked about kickoffs, you and I, before the game. And I'm talking with a referee, and we talked about a lot of the differences in high school and college and pro football. Everybody watches the weekend, you know. Whether we have the Browns and Bengals, Steelers, whoever people watch in this area. But one of the things is on the kickoff, when a ball goes out of bounds in high school, that coach has 3 choices he can make. He can take the ball at the 35-yard line. He can take it at the spot if it happens to be better than that.
Uh-huh.
Or he can take a 5-yard penalty and have
make
the team re-kick it.
Yeah, right.
So, you know, there's just a lot of differences between the rules. And sometime, not necessarily tonight, but we'll get in and talk about some of those differences. I found it very interesting, Jared, some of the subtleties of it all.
The kicker for the Aces is Zach Meadows, a freshman. He's a soccer player. And his brother, Christian Meadows, who's a senior, used to kick for them. And he has now committed to, it looks like, playing full-time football. And the return will be brought up across the 40-yard line to about the 41. So the Falcons will take over. They lead it 6-0 here as we begin second half play. They'll have great field position at the 44 to start this drive.
Well, sometimes the first drive for each team in the second half determines the football game or has a big impact on it. So let's see here what happens. I believe it has stopped raining, Jared.
It's a handoff to Heston, and Heston bowling his way forward for about 5 yards.
He's had a really good night rushing the football.
Oh, maybe it hasn't stopped raining.
I heard that, and somebody in the truck said it was going to stop.
7 o'clock is what they said. It's 8:15 now.
They're talking Pacific time, right?
Must have a real meteorologist down there.
In all honesty, it's not blasting on our windows now.
That's true,
big difference.
Here's Will Young up the left sideline. Lots of running room, one man to beat.
Good
Gets block. A block, and it's a touchdown for the Falcons.
Had him stepped out of bounds back here.
Did they?
Nope. I thought so.
It is a touchdown.
I saw the official stop, but he was addressing one of the coaches on the Amanda sideline.
I think that's Coach Hinton. He's out past where he's supposed to be.
He's probably fortunate he didn't get a yellow hanky.
You're right.
Yeah.
He's still out past where he's supposed to be. And Coach Hinton over about the 22-yard line has hands out wondering, I don't know, if maybe he saw, maybe he thought he stepped out or something.
I don't know.
But it is a touchdown for the Falcons. And Will Young, who just ran it in, will kick the extra point.
Big, big play in the game.
Yeah, it was. And we have a whistle and a timeout. The Falcons will take it.
Boy, you hate to use
57
seconds into the third quarter because you're disorganized.
Coach Bain is leading the charge in that huddle. I'm sure he's not happy about having to take one.
No, I wouldn't be very happy right now that, you know, you're not organized enough to get your extra point team on and off the field.
At this point, Shu, you know, you're up 12-0. Would you think about going for two to get it up to 14? Or
I think it's a little early to chase those points, to be honest with you. Maybe at the next score, possibly.
Yeah.
But right now, I think you go ahead because
the defense has been playing good.
They
really
have
good.
Been. And Amanda has a good kicker.
Yeah.
But the bottom line is, in these conditions, who knows?
True.
If I could get a point, I'd try to get it right now.
So Will Young will kick it out of the hold of Spencer Conrad. The kick is up, and it is good this time. Booted it through, and that puts the Falcons up 13-0 with just 11:03 showing on the clock here in the third quarter. What would that take, 57 seconds to score?
Yeah, not a drive. as we say, it's a summary. It's a scoring summary. Is two plays, 57 yards, and what a run there. I broke it and got open, and no chance of the Amanda players catching him. Now, this is kind of a gut check for the Aces
right now,
Jared. You know, we talked about the first possession for each team in the half. Now you got to find out if how they're going to come back. They even if they don't score, they've got to match them to gain some field position. But you're going to run out of opportunities eventually, and you don't want to rely on trying to pass the ball tonight to catch
right.
it. You know, Coach Hinton said an interesting thing in his conversation that he had with you is that neither team plays really well from behind. And right now, they're kind of behind the eight ball.
Yeah, you're right. Kickoff will be taken at the 26-yard line. They couldn't pick it up. Try and see who that is. He could not get the handle on it. So he did the smart thing, just fell on it. I think that was R.J. Martin. No, check that. It's Lance Clevenger. For the Aces. So Amanda Clear Creek will go on offense for the first time here in this second half. They'll start 1st and 10 at the 28-yard line. I'm sure you had to go and say something about the rain not being on our window. Now it is again.
Well, that all started in the truck. You know that.
Neff hands it off to Leisure over the right tackle. Leisure, look at him churning his feet, still going, and that's a good gain of about 8.
I love his will.
So that's carry number 18 on the night, right?
Yeah, he just got such a will and a drive to be good.
So give him 8. So 2nd down and 2. Slazier again. He's got the first down and more. Burst of speed. He's got two men to beat. I don't think they're going to catch him. He's at the 20, and they will dive for him and not get him. Touchdown, Jordan Slazier and the Aces.
62 yards, Jared.
We've seen a couple tonight where it looked like he was going to break him, and he either slipped or somebody got a shoestring up on him, but that time he was off to the races.
Yeah, no chance right there. I tell you, what a great job by the Aces to match.
That was important for them to match right there.
It was critical. You know, now we've got us a ball game again. Yeah. You know, we're right back really where we started at halftime at this point.
Well, we saw 6 points scored in the entire first half, and we've already had 13 here in this second half. So Meadows comes on to kick the extra point. High snap, and the kick is no good.
See, that's why I thought it was big to kick that point earlier, Jared.
And there's a player down for the Falcons. Here's the replay of the run for Jordan Slazier.
Yeah, just watch. I mean, once he gets this crease, he got his footing here, too. I think that's critical. See the cut he made?
Yep.
And then he just runs through and by
he wasn't the touched.
Defenders. No, he just. But you're looking at a state qualifier, 110-meter hurdle. So he's got a little bit extra jolt there.
Give Hunter Sunkel a credit for hustling down there and tried to make the tackle. And I believe that's Hunter right there that's hurt on the extra point.
Yeah, I'm glad to see him getting up.
Not sure what he's favoring. Just maybe get the wind knocked out of him.
Yeah, I hope it's something that simple. Not that it feels good.
Right.
It's a lot better than any kind of a leg injury.
You know, this week there's been a lot in the news about high school football nationally.
Yep.
After the 3-year starting quarterback up in New Jersey, high school football player ruptured spleen and had internal bleeding and died on his way to the hospital, leaving the football game.
You know, one's too many, but fortunately the percentage of kids that are involved, it is extremely, extremely low.
Yep.
Considering how physical the game is and how hard it's played. And I think, you know, the National Federation has tried to do a nice job of making it a safer game.
Right.
But unfortunately, things happen, and as I said, one's too many. I mean, the loss of one young athlete's way too many. But doggone it, how many kids are playing tonight in just in the state of Ohio?
Yeah. And I, unfortunately, you know, a young man that I went to high school with, 2 years after I graduated from high school, this kid was a senior, and I was actually doing a game on the radio at Meigs High School. They were playing at Waverly, and a young man came off the field, collapsed on his way to the locker room, and died the next morning at the hospital, brain aneurysm. And they traced it back. He had been taking several hits to the head in games previous to that, and this was back in 1996.
Wow.
So they've done a lot of changes, obviously, since then with helmets and things like that, but that one definitely hit close to home.
Yeah, that's not easy.
Pretty good kickoff right there for the Aces. It got all the way down to about the 20, and in conditions like this, you'll take that.
Well, you know, I think really they've had success with their kicking game over the years.
Yeah.
Amanda has, and
I believe their kicker is Zach Meadows, but the number listed is 88, and I don't have 88 listed. Christian Meadows is 87. Zach Meadows is 32. Might have just changed jerseys or something.
Yeah, in this situation. I mean, I think if I'm like Jordan Slazier, I'm not changing mine. It's slippery as heck right now.
Absolutely.
You know?
Here's a handoff. Heston. And another good run on first down for Mr. Heston up to about a 7-yard gain.
They've done a really good job on that inside handoff.
Keaton Baldwin and Alan Reed.
Watch here.
Stop.
Just a little short trap and pull, and boy, he just busts through. Nice gain.
Baldwin has been in a lot of tackles. He's been their leading tackler. They're actually missing Michael Seitz, who's a big contributor to their team, he went out with a knee injury, out for the season. 2 years in a row, that poor kid has suffered a knee injury. That's a big loss for their offense and their defense. Here's a handoff again on second down. That's up close to a first down.
Yeah, it's a little inside, little fake toss and inside counter there, and nice gain again for the Falcons. Get him a white hat, right?
Yeah.
Hey, that's okay. I would want my players to have that enthusiasm.
Especially, you know, he's a lineman. He's opening up the holes for those running backs. Get excited about
it. Yeah, as long as you're not taunting or whatever. Right. I love that enthusiasm.
There's another good run on first down, a pickup of 5 on the play. They'll take 5 every down.
Oh, they've done a great job. I mean, when you're getting 5 on first down, Jared, that just sets up the rest of the series of plays here to gain 10. Makes it much easier.
Yeah. Second and 5 for the Falcons. Young again with Braden Heston behind him. Schultz is back there as well. Here's Heston. And another first down run.
Yeah. You know, and just the, you know, we talked about Jordan and his will, and I love Heston. He just busting through there, and he has a great will to get up through there. And, you know, Brayden's only a junior.
Yeah.
I really, really like how he's handling himself tonight.
Jacob Figgins brings the play in for the Falcons. First and 10 near midfield. Clock rolls down to 8:07 to play here in this third quarter. Sunkel went in motion. Good to see him back in the game. And on the handoff, not much there.
Now, good job by that time. You know, Manda finally got some penetration and got off block and plugged the hole.
So no gain, second down and 10.
Now the pressure goes back on the Fairfield offense here. You know, they've had second and 5 two straight times. Now you're down to second and 10. See what they can pull out here and see if they can continue to make this drive work.
They'll actually give them a gain of a yard, so it's second and 9 now. Young hands it off to Schultz. Schultz has some running room up across the 45, and he's got a first down. The ball's loose, and it's going to go out of bounds. That's a break for Fairfield Union. It was stripped out of there by the Aces.
Amanda's done a nice job all night attacking the football and trying to create a turnover by stripping. Yeah. If you don't protect it, you know, you can see defensively that they're taught to reach and grab. Nice play. Schultz shows his speed here. Nice cut again.
Look who it is that gets in there to try to strip it, Jordan Leisure.
Yeah, but watch.
Wow.
Yep. And it hit his foot, I believe, before it went out of bounds.
So a break for the Falcons. But again, that's one of those where it's spotted where he's down, right? You can't move the ball forward where it goes out of bounds?
No, it does. It does. I think it went up 3 yards.
Did it?
Yeah.
Fake right up the middle, and Young keeps it himself. Maybe picks up one.
Yeah, that's your fake and follow right there. Trying to get another athlete, you know, an extra blocker in front of him.
Tell you what, as wet and muddy as those footballs are getting out there, Bob might need to throw in the Promotions by Design IVP football.
That'd be interesting.
Give him a dry one out there. Catherine Cheek and the gang over at Promotions by Design, they've provided us with some footballs that we try to give out to either fans of the game or trivia winners, and unfortunately tonight, going to be tough to get a trivia winner in this weather. Here's Nick Schultz. Oh, took a big hit. The ball's loose again, and I think the Aces got it this time.
Yep, they do.
Who fell on it? I think it was R.J. Martin.
Oh, he's hurt.
Came away with it.
He's hurt pretty bad here.
Who is Schultz?
I can't tell the number.
Oh, yeah. 62, I think it is. Yeah, he is a mess.
He was having a hard time getting going, so fortunately he's walked off to the sideline. It's like 22, maybe.
I think it's, is it? Or is that 32 again? Sunko again. His jersey's so muddy,
it's
I can't
hard
even
to tell.
Tell.
Yeah, it is.
I think it is 32, Hunter Sunko.
Well, big play again by Amanda. You know, the Falcons not protecting the football.
Yep.
You know, the fastest way for a ball carrier not to get more carries is put it on the ground.
Yeah, he fumbled it twice in a row, and Schultz is kind of shaking his hand right now. Might have hurt himself on that last fumble. Neff will hand it off to Leisure. Leisure trying to get to the outside, and he hops over one defender, and he's still on his feet across the 50. Look at this kid go. Finally out of bounds up across the 40. What'd you say? He was a hurdler?
Oh, yeah.
Came into effect right there.
Yeah, the 110s.
He pulls out a towel to try to wipe off his hands, but I'm not sure there's a dry spot on his towel. Watch this replay. Man, just impressive run.
Yeah, 22 yards. He just has
he's a man
great
on the
determination.
In this
yeah, his determination's incredible.
Here he is again. Same play, trying to get to the outside, dragging people with him up near the 30. Another close to a first down run. You know, one thing, Shu, this has been a pretty sounds crazy to say clean game with it being muddy out there, but we haven't seen very many penalties. Obviously, Fairfield Union, the first two plays of the game defensively, they had penalties, but since then it's been, you know, fairly clean game as far as penalties go.
Yep, you're right. Considering we haven't had a lot of stoppages and a lot of yellow flags at all.
Going to spot the ball up at the 31, I believe. Second down and two.
It's about the 33,
the
Jared.
Down markers.
The down, where
a little
the down
off.
Marker
He's
is.
Way off. There's Leisure again. And he's up across the 30, close to a first down. Going to be short.
You think?
I don't know. It's close. I think they're going to maybe have to measure this one.
I think that's a first down.
Referee's taking a look at it, and he is going to call for the chains. So 5:34, clock stop to measure to see if Jordan Leisure picked up this first down. And while they bring the chains out, I want to thank DiBerio's Pizzeria. They provide quality ingredients and exceptional service. Their menu items include pizza, pasta, stromboli, and subs. For carryout or delivery, they can be reached at 740-654-2317. That's DiBerio's Pizzeria. As they stretch out the chains, there it is, a first down for the Aces.
Yeah, I just thought from the angle we had a pretty good look at that one.
So what's Leisure up to now?
Well, to do quick math.
That's your specialty.
I know, he has 174 yards on 22 carries right now. Because this quarter alone, he has 102 yards.
I wish that we had a camera in the press box. You've just got numbers written down, and you just look at them and say, that's 174 yards. Amazing. Can't get anything by this guy.
Yeah, tonight I could be a Rain Man tonight, you know.
First and 10 Aces. Here's Leisure again. Hops over a man, and a flag comes down. I think that's going to be.
Oh, my.
Yeah. That's going to go against the Aces, a hold. How many carries is he up to?
Wow, that was his 23rd.
Wow. And we're still.
Five minutes in the third quarter. Now, you know, he doesn't get.
So our Fleet Master's call backs it up 10 yards on the Aces. Logan Elm leads Liberty Union 28-7. That's in the third quarter down at Logan Elm. Again, Terry Holbert got his troops moving in the right direction after that week one loss.
Yeah, the Braves have been playing it.
They have. First and 10 Aces. Leisure, this time going nowhere. Coming in there for the Falcons, number 11 and number 13. That's Jared Porter and Michael Jude. I believe it's no gain on the carry. So second and 23.
There's 21 here on the board, but math-wise, looking at the – looks 24 from here.
Yeah, 24, close to 25.
If the marker's right.
Again, it's Leisure, and he never did touch down, so he kind of tries to spin through there. Man, look at the mud.
I know.
He's
tremendous.
Watch this. I think he gets 2 yards on the carry, but.
What's that called? Slip sliding away?
Yeah. Right there, he never did touch down, just his hand. So he tried to get up and go again, but just couldn't get the wheels turning. Again, Jordan Leisure up the middle and across the 40. Give him, what, 4 on that one? So it looks like the Aces will bring out the punt team, try to play the field position game here.
Now they've had some success. You know, Jordan's put them over there by the far number mark. The hash isn't even available anymore, but he's done a nice job kicking that ball down in the corner.
At this point, you know, you got to hope your snapper can get a snap, and there it's on the ground. And Laser is going to have trouble holding on to it. He's just going to run it. He's got some room. Up to the 30, and he's going to be very close to a first down. He's diving for it. I think he got it. Unbelievable.
Oh, my.
On a bad snap, then a muff punt, he's able to run it all the way up, what, 20 yards for a first down?
He had 18 to get the first down, I think, to get the mark.
Wow. They're not going to give it to him. They're Sam Fairfield Union ball. It looked to me like when he dove.
They might have had him down before. You know, he might have been on
his
knee.
Let's see it here.
I mean.
So that's the original line of scrimmage there.
Yeah, he's hurtling, pushing. I thought right here when he was one-on-one.
To the 20. Dives. He's at the 20. Ball's across the 20.
But they spotted him short.
They're still having a discussion over there. The officials are still discussing it. Are they now going to measure it? I think they're going to measure. At first they said Falcon ball. Now it looks like they're going to measure. On our replay, it clearly looked like he stretched out for the first down.
Wow.
After measuring, they say he did not get it.
What a break for the Falcons.
I'd say.
I'm not sure. I just wouldn't put him in pump formation and hike it to him and let him run wherever he wants.
Yeah. Now, does that obviously counts as rushing
yards. That's rushing yardage,
Here again. I mean, obviously, we can't see a knee.
No, I don't know
whether.
He's
up in the air
see,
there.
See, I think they're marking him down there, Jared.
How?
Right there. How do we know?
Or maybe it's forward progress, they're saying.
Yeah. I don't know.
There's a burst up the middle by Heston. Good run of about 7 for him.
You know, that run officially put him at 200 yards tonight.
Wow. 200 yards in the mud.
With 2:40 to go in the third quarter.
That's impressive.
It is.
Braden Heston, the junior.
Braden's had a heck of a game, too. I'd like to have and know his numbers.
Second down and two for Fairfield Union. Of course, everybody bunched in tight there like they have been all night. And not much there this time.
Yeah, good job. I believe it was 74. His number kind of shone through
the
mud.
Max Smith.
Did a real good job, Jared. I think it was 74. I know it ended in four, so we're guessing from there.
Should I say? I think that the rain has stopped. Or are we going to have a camera
angle?
A camera angle that makes me a liar.
Nah.
Our window's clear now, at least.
Well, I just did the window man commercial.
That's true.
You know, that's it. We've got to do that.
Look at that. Yet. I think we're clear. 2 hours late. An hour and 45 late.
But who's counting?
Here's Heston. Heston bounces off his own man, has a first down, and more.
Oh, the boys in the mud tonight.
Say there's a soccer game here tomorrow?
Not on this field.
Can they play it all down between the
there's no
20
way.
And the goal line on the other side?
There's no way that'll be happening here.
First and 10 Falcons at their own 36-yard line. They lead it 13-6. Clock rolls down. 1:11 to play here in this third quarter. Will Young under center. Keeps it himself right up the middle and does not get to the 40. Stopped just shy. It's a pickup of about three or four on the play. Keaton Baldwin again on the stop for the Aces. Clock inside of 30 seconds now and counting here in the third quarter. Young hands it off to Heston and going to be stopped after maybe a yard.
Yeah, really good job by the Aces defense that time.
So time will run out here in the third quarter as the Aces take a 13-6 lead into the final quarter of play. I'm sorry, the Falcons take a 13-6 lead into the final quarter of play. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back with the final 12 minutes coming up next on the High School Football Game of the Week.
How to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
We are back at Fairfield Union as the Falcons take a 13-6 lead into the final 12 minutes of play here. They have third down and six at their own 41-yard line. Will Young under center sends his man in motion and hands it off to Nick Schultz. And Schultz gets up near the 45. That's going to be shy of the first down.
One team looks like light mud, and the other one looks like dark mud.
Yeah, you're right.
You know.
So the Falcons will be forced to punt. Heading back to receive it, I think, is Keaton Baldwin, I believe, and R.J. Martin, or Lance Clevenger, that is. End over end punt.
Oh,
and
my.
And takes the Falcon bounce, but then just dies in the mud. And that's going to be down at the 14-yard line.
Yeah, really good punt. 42 yards with no return. You'll take that.
You know, if with grass out there, that one might roll back inside the five.
Well, it also might have been caught because the receiver was having a hard time getting his footing.
Yep. There you see the look at that. The radar there shows just a little bit more rain. I think it's already passed.
The worst of it has to be.
Yeah.
I mean, there's just no doubt.
All coming up from that hurricane. You typically don't see rain coming that way in our area. Officials have a stoppage of play for some reason. Head referee is coming over to the Fairfield Union side. Look at that, 44 degrees. It feels like 39.
I'm pretty comfortable in here, though.
Well, we've got a little crack in the window here, right beside me, and I tell you, for just a little crack, it's chilly, so not just sitting out in it.
Oh, you're getting softer, I know.
So first and 10 for the Aces. At this point, it's kind of a crapshoot on numbers. We can't see anything, especially on the white jerseys of the Aces.
Well, I can tell when Leisure's running.
Right, just by his, by the way he runs. Neff's going to keep. No, he fumbled it.
Yeah, he did.
Luckily for him, he's able to pick it up and go ahead for about a yard.
And the ball is marked right in the middle of the mud. They're in probably the worst spot on the field.
Yep.
I don't think there's any doubt.
It's weird. I mean, almost the entire game has been played right there between the 10 and the 40 on the left side.
A lot of it has definitely taken place right there.
Second down and 8. They'll give him 2. Man in motion for the Aces. Here's Leisure on the carry. Trying to break some tackles, and he's going to be wrapped up near the 20-yard line. Another gain of about 2 on the play. Brings up 3rd down and 5 for Amanda Clear Creek.
Big, big play right here in the start of the fourth quarter, Jared, because if you can stop the Aces, if you're looking at it from Fairfield Union's view, you're going to have good field position. And obviously for the Aces, it keeps your drive alive.
Yeah.
Being down a touchdown and an extra point.
Neff sends a man in motion, pitches it out to Leisure. Leisure tries to cut back. He was hit almost immediately. Number 3, who I don't have on my roster. You have him on that one over there, Shoe?
Yeah, that was Falcons. Well defended that time. That's Ray Petros.
Okay.
Coach Steve Petros' son.
Must have changed his number. So 4th down. And the Aces will punt. I think it was no gain on the play, so it's 4th and 5. Last punt they tried, it was a bad snap, and then Leisure couldn't hold on to the ball, but he almost ran it for a first down. This is an end-over-end short kick. Takes an Aces bounce, and will be downed at the Falcon 49-yard line.
And, again, good field position for the Falcons here, and this is their opportunity here. First drive of this quarter for them. They could really put Amanda in a very, very difficult position if they can drive the football.
Yeah, you're right. Coming up next week, we've got a big game that you'll see. We'll be at Fulton Field as the Lancaster Gaels, who look to go 6-0 after tonight. They, at last check, were leading at Groveport at halftime. If they can win that one, they'll be 6-0, taking on Gahanna Lincoln in their homecoming game next Friday night. That'll be a big one.
Yeah, that'll be a doozy. Gahanna always has a good football team.
First and 10 Falcons. Hand off. Here's Heston. Up across the 50 to the 48. 47. Give him a gain of 4. Second down and 6. Young taking his time. Pitches it back to Schultz, and Schultz loses it, and he's able to fall on it, but that's a big loss on the play. Fortunately for Nick, he was able to just recover it.
Yes.
That would be huge if the Aces were to recover that one. Kind of went right through his hands. Loss of about 10 on the play. Third down and 15. Clock rolls down to 7.5 minutes to play in the ball game. Both teams have missed an extra point tonight, so if the Aces were to score eventually, they would have to have that extra point to tie it. But the Falcons right here want to try to convert. It's a reverse. There's some running room. Will Young getting a block for his running back and getting up near midfield. That's Sunkel on the run.
Yeah, positive gain right there. people are tippy-toeing a little bit and trying to get their traction. Yeah. It's just hard right now to really gain anything. And if you're not going direct, straight line, it's tough to run.
Landon Roberts and Lance Clevenger go back for the Falcons to receive the punt. It'll be Will Young to do the punting.
Well, for the Aces, big. That's big there because, you know, they get the ball right back, and pending the punt, what kind of field position?
Oh, good punt.
Real good punt.
And it will go into the end zone.
He hit one of the dry spots on the field tonight, I think.
I think
that's
so.
That bounce, yeah.
That was a boomer.
That still puts him at the 20, and you know, you're going to make him drive 80 yards, and you're up a touchdown with 7 minutes. You can't ask more out of your team, Coach
right.
Bain. You know, I mean, you're in a position where you just have to get it done now.
So the Aces will have first and 10 at the 20, trailing 13-6, 6:58 showing on the clock. Both teams looking for win number one in the Buckeye Division of the Mid-State League for this year. Falcons looking for their first one in 21 tries. Right now they are clinging to that 7-point lead. Players on the sideline trying to get their fans into it. Neff back to pass, fires one over the middle. It's Baldwin. He's open at the 40 to the midfield. Here goes Keaton Baldwin down the middle of the field and all the way down to the 35-yard line.
Huge call. Huge call, huge execution for the Aces.
I think just the second pass they've thrown tonight.
I think you're right. If you remember, the first one was
intercepted.
Yeah. So in actuality, he's completed both passes.
Here it is.
I mean, he put it out there. Now he's wide open, but you still got to put it there.
Yep. And then Baldwin just did the rest with his legs. Nick Schultz did a good job tracking him down. But the ace is on the move here. It's Lazier out of the shotgun. And the chains weren't even up ready to go.
Officials got to get that
taken
care of.
They need to stop that because they'll give him a gain of 3, I believe.
Is that right?
Yeah, Brad Wolf made the stop, so it's second down and 7. Tom Russo on the camera there. Looks a little drier. There's a pitch out to Lazier. Not going to get to the outside this time. Swarming defense by the Falcons. J. Jacob Figgins led the way.
Yeah, that's a couple yards loss, isn't
yeah.
it? Yeah. That took him back. You know, they're calling it a loss of three.
So third and 10. Going to be four down territory here, though. Neff rolling to pass. And it's almost intercepted. He overthrew his intended receiver, who was Baldwin again. And Petros almost came away with the interception.
I tell you what, he has that. He has a clear path.
Yep, not a soul in front of him.
No.
So fourth and 10 here for Amanda Clear Creek.
5:20 to go. You don't have any decision to make at all here except for what play you're going to run.
And he only told the play to the linemen and the running backs. The receivers knew what to do. They've got twins to the right, twins to the left. Neff back to pass. He's pressured. Shovel pass. And yep. That's not going anywhere.
Now, the Falcons totally sniffed that out. Tried to set a little screen there, yep. You know. And the Falcons did not bite.
So nice job by Fairfield Union coming up with some big defense there. And they will take over on downs, first and 10.
You can see it here. No chance.
Uh-uh. Official talking to Will Young in the huddle. You've talked about this before, Shu. The back judge will hold his hand up when
yes.
it's 5 seconds, correct?
That is correct. So you know, and you can practice that scenario in practice weekly to know how you're going to operate in game time situations which involve the use of the clock.
Yeah.
There's not a reason at all that you should not be able to execute if you have enough time to practice each week to understand how that's interpreted. You know, we don't have the game clock like the college yeah. and professional in front of you, but he is a game clock. By the time he raises his hand, you have 5 seconds from that point to get that ball snapped.
Some high schools now do have the game clock.
Or really?
In the end zones.
I think we saw it at Carroll last year, but, you know, you have to have somebody that operates it and knows how to
right.
operate it.
Young keeps it himself and maybe gets a yard there. Or no gain, third down and 5 for Fairfield Union. Aces need a stop here. Clock continues to count down, 4:14 and counting. Young again will have Heston right behind him. He splits out. Nick Bishop out wide to the right. He waits for that back judge to raise his hand. Hands it off to Heston up the middle. Heston very close to a first down.
I think he got it by the mark that I see.
Yeah, does look like it.
Big, big play. Wow, what a burst.
Great job by Braden Heston. That's going to take the clock down inside of 4 minutes and counting here to play in the ball game. Falcons need to protect the football. Young again waits for the back judge to raise his hand. There it is. And I think Young kept it himself this time. Trying to break some tackles. He's doing so, but not going to be a whole lot of a gain there. Maybe two. So So we have a timeout on the field. And, Shue, I think we have one more sponsor we want to thank tonight.
We certainly do. Let's say thanks to the Window Man. The Window Man of Lancaster's customers expect the best, and that's what they deliver. From your initial contact with their knowledgeable representatives through the installation of those products by experienced, detail-oriented craftsmen, we know you'll be happy with the service you receive and, most importantly, their results. They are located in Lancaster at 721 Union Street, or you can visit them at thewindowmanoflancaster.com.
And we want to remind you, too, that not only now can you see the game on LSN and you can see the Buffalo Wild Wings, but now if you go to the Interphase Video Productions Facebook page, there it is, there will be a link there, and you can click on that link starting the day after the game, and you can watch the game anytime you want. It'll take you straight to the YouTube video of the game, so that's a new feature we have, and there's no reason anybody should miss a game this year.
Not at all. And the bottom line is you don't have to be able to log into Facebook. Right. It just comes up and you have access to it.
Yeah, you don't have to have an account.
No, you don't have to be a member or any of those kind of things. I've had officials tell me they've watched it on there and been such a clear picture and good coverage and been very complimentary.
Yeah. Second down and 8 for the Falcons. Out of the timeout. Sunkel goes in motion. It's a handoff to Heston up the middle. Took a hard hit, but kept on going. I think he was dazed there for a second.
Kind of like the Energizer Bunny there. He kind of went
but
back.
But he kept on
then,
going.
Yeah, he did.
Boy, he's got to be up close to 250 now, don't you think? 250 yards?
He's had a heck of a night. I don't know what his numbers are, but they've been pretty doggone good.
Clock down inside of 3 minutes, 2.5. I think the Aces have, what, one more timeout?
They have two timeouts to go. I'm kind of surprised, but they're kind of waiting to see if they're going to, you know, be able to get a stop on this third down. Which is a pretty good call by their staff.
Young hands it off to Heston. Heston fights forward and has another first down.
He sure does, and just on desire. Boy, now you put the Aces in a tough spot right here,
yep.
Jared. They got to send everybody here on first down, get a stop, and then use your two timeouts.
Yep.
Because more than the Falcons being your opponent, the clock has now become their opponent.
So first and 10 for Fairfield Union, clock down to 2:04 and counting. They're starting to taste the drought being over, but they have to protect the football. Young again sends Sunkel in motion, hands it off to Heston right up the middle, and that's a gain of 3 on the play.
He takes that first hit, and then he just keeps his legs moving.
Coach Hinton and the Aces will take a timeout with a minute 39 to play in the ball game, and that gives us a chance to congratulate our players of the game. And Shue, let's do the Amanda Clear Creek Edwards Insurance Agency player of the game. First of all, Edwards Insurance Agency specializes in providing personalized insurance coverage that meets the needs of our individual clients. You can call contact Todd or Dale Edwards today.
Well, I think we just have to name Jordan Leisure. We've said his name all night on both sides of the ball. He punts, he does everything. He's had a tremendous ball game, not just statistically. I mean, he's carried the ball 31 times and has 208 yards. So he's been statistically good, but he's also been very, very good at just his leadership, his will, his effort. And he just exemplifies a lot of things that you want a high school athlete to exemplify.
So congratulations to our Amanda Clear Creek Edwards Insurance Agency Player of the Game. And we will get to the Fairfield Union, Fairfield National Bank Player of the Game after this next play. And I don't think it's any secret who that one's going to be either. We'll tell you about that one in just a moment. Second down and 7, minute 39 on the clock for the Falcons. Aces just have one more timeout. Young again hands it off to Heston. He faked it. And Will Young on a loss there, and the Aces will take a timeout. Here's a big third down right here. They take the timeout with a minute 34. So tonight's Fairfield Union Player of the Game brought to you by Fairfield National Bank. Have you wondered if this is the right time to buy a home or build one? Want to know what you can afford? What options are out there? What's the next step? Fairfield National Bank is already helping many people who dreamed of a new home make it happen this year. Our lenders give you straight answers, and we make decisions locally so you can get the money you need quickly. Fairfield National Bank is a division of Park National Bank, equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Well, for the Falcons, how about Braden Heston? He has been dynamite tonight. You know, we talk about all the things that Jordan Leisure brings to the table. Braden showed the same kind of things, the will, the desire, the great effort. And just, you know, he leads by his effort.
Yes.
And tremendous effort. Obviously, he's got people in front of him doing it, moving people. But he just gives that little extra effort that's very easily identifiable.
There he is, number 36, Braden Heston, the junior. For the Falcons, congratulations on being our Fairfield National Bank Player of the Game. Third down and 10 here for the Falcons. Young hands it off to Schultz. Schultz still on his feet. He has a first down and more. Schultz is off to the races. Two men to beat. He's down inside the 20, and that's probably going to seal it, Shue.
Well, how about covering the football that time? Did you see he had a little more awareness of making sure he protected the football? That's what I noticed.
Yeah, he's had some trouble earlier tonight with holding onto the football, and he was not going to lose it this time.
And I think you give Coach Bain credit there for being able to give the ball back to him. I don't know if I could or some coach could, but he gave back to him. Now watch him protect. As he starts to feel pressure, he gets both hands on it and don't give it up.
Right.
Because he's a talented runner.
Yes, he is. So clock down to a minute 28 counting. The Aces cannot stop it again. The only thing they can hope for here is a stop or a turnover.
Now, at this point, I don't know why you just don't just go to the knee.
Yeah, just kneel on it. Young will wait for that back judge to put his hand up. There it is, 5 seconds. He will hand it off to Heston. And Heston will move forward for about a yard or two. And we are inside of a minute. And Fairfield Union will just have to snap it one more time. Fans are starting to come to their feet. The players on the sidelines, they're ready to already go ring that victory bell. As the clock rolls down to 30 seconds. One more snap and a kneel down. And the Falcons will be victorious. They get into that victory formation. Get a good tight shot down there on it. As Will Young will take a knee, and the Falcons' drought is over.
On a night when there was definitely no drought.
That's true. So the 21-game Mid-State League Buckeye Division drought losing streak is gone. The Falcons win it tonight over the Aces 13-6 on homecoming night. And what a way for these fans, these students, to celebrate a losing streak, but to do it against, ending a losing streak, to do it against your rival and on homecoming night.
What a great effort by both teams, Jared.
Right.
I just thought it was just outstanding effort. I mean, we already highlighted Braden Heston and Jordan Leisure. But overall, the teams in general, I just thought the effort was big. I thought Fairfield Union had two really good defensive stands also in that quarter that made that stand up. You know, they got burned on that pass play, and Amanda had the ball deep inside territory, and their defense stood up tall and strong. And made them turn the ball over and down. So give the Falcons credit. You know, you got them a league win. They're now at 500 for the season.
Yeah.
That's got to feel good. And for Coach Hinton's team, he's got to feel like, wow, what do we got to do? We're giving great effort. What do we got to do to get a victory? And you know what? I'm sure they'll go back to work, keep positive, and come out plugging next week.
Tonight's final stats are brought to you by Don's Furniture and Mattress, located at 1118 East Main Street. They've been serving Lancaster and Fairfield County for 23 years. Over those years, Don's has supported numerous charities and youth sports teams, and they continue to support our community. Don's values every customer and wishes all area teams a successful season. To find out more, you can visit them on the web at donsfurniture.com. And Beth Competti has our stats ready, and we will show those to you as the Falcons celebrate a win here tonight. There you go.
Look at the rushing yards, 292 for the Falcons. They did a great job at their running game tonight. Obviously, Heston on the inside, and as we talked about, Schultz and Young being really, really good runners also. Jordan Leisure, what can you say, for for the Aces. 5 penalties in the whole game, but the Falcons had some offense tonight. Now, they didn't put a lot of points on the board, but when you have 12 first downs, that shows that they were moving the ball a little bit, and I think they're going to continue to get better as they've made this adjustment in their offense.
So congratulations to Fairfield Union. We mentioned it. They snapped that 21-game losing streak as the rain begins to fall again here just as the game ends. But congratulations again. A 13-6 win on homecoming night for Coach Bain and his Falcons. For all of our crew and for Tim Shoemaker, I'm Jared Stewart. Have yourselves a great night, everybody.
IVP Sports has brought you the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Ohio University Lancaster, R.N. Smith Heating and Cooling, Tiki Bowling Lanes, Sheridan Funeral Home, Tiberio's Ristorante, Fairfield DD, the Edwards Insurance Agency, the Huddle Tire Company, the Lancaster Eagle Gazette, Fairfield National Bank, Personal Touch Party Rentals, Fairfield Federal, Don's Furniture, Kumler Collision and Automotive, The Carriage Company, the Fairfield Center for Disabilities, Fleet Masters, The Window Man, Ohio Christian University, the Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, North Body Shop, Kirkbride Lawn Care, Wall-to-Wall Floors, and Standing Stone Bank. This has been an IVP Sports production.
For more than 50 years, the Fairfield Center for Disabilities and Cerebral Palsy has been encouraging hope and fostering relationships for individuals with disabilities and cerebral palsy. The center has created a community within our local community through rich, vibrant programming. Its adult day services offered 5 days a week includes activities both at the center and at locations throughout the community. The center has something for each individual to connect with others and foster their unique interests and skills, helping them to lead enriched and independent lives. Through these programs, the center is constantly evolving services to meet the changing needs of Fairfield County residents with disabilities and helping to encourage hope and foster relationships, truly building a community.